Hello everyone, welcome back. Happy Dashera and Vijayadashmi to all of you. So I'm up and back with my new video. So as you can see this beautiful view behind me, that's because I'm on the top of the Nandi Hills, which is a very famous tourist destination about 60 kilometers away from the Bangalore city. And 10 kilometers away is the nearest town, which is Chikbalapura. So today is Vijayadashmi and we thought, because this year I told you that Durga Puja is not being celebrated grandly, so we thought, why do we need to sit at home when we stay in a place where there are so many things to explore? Even though I've come to Nandi Hills like several times before, but still, you know, it's a nice place, so you can visit it many times. So we left in the morning. First we went to the Devanahalli Fort, it is the birthplace of the very famous Tipu Sultan who ruled our South India. And after that we came towards Nandi Hills and you can see this beautiful view behind me. So it's a very nice place. It's very windy now, even though if you see the normal climate is very hot and sunny. So let me tell you a little bit about this place. So this place is called the Nandi Hills mostly because the hill resembles a sleeping bull, while there are other sources which tell us that this place was basically a fort called the Nandi Durg. So Durg is a word describing fort. So this place was previously called the Nandi Durg and it was built by the rulers of the Ganga dynasty so that they could protect their territories. So later on, after the dynasty fell, we all know that there was this Mughal period in India. So that time Tipu Sultan took over this place and he strengthened the fort and made it a more stronger place and used it as a stronger base for his reign. So there are many points of interest over here according to traditions, and few of them are also proved. There are sources of river Arkavati and river Pomperi and so many other four or five rivers, and here you can also see them if you wanna. So I'm going to that later. So this place was used by Tipu Sultan also as a place of persecution. Nowadays what we see is the traitors or the people who are working for the other side, the enemy side. The maximum thing which can happen is giving them a hanging sentence to death. But that time Tipu Sultan did not use that. What he did was, there is a Tipu Fall Point where he used to get those traitors and the people who were loyal to the British instead of being loyal to the dynasty of Tipu Sultan, and used to push them down instead of using the hanging sentence. So this place also holds a lot of history, and when the Britishers came over, they actually did not use this place as a territory anymore. They just used it for recreation. They built some palaces and they used this for enjoyment because it's such a nice place up here. You can actually have a lot of fun. So Britishers were the first ones who introduced this place as a tourist spot, and people started coming and started seeing the beauty of this place, and they also put this place into use of vegetation. There's potato vegetation down in the village Nandi, plus this place is really famous for the grapes which grows here. Black grapes, most probably they are black grapes itself, but we do have green grapes here. So this was about the Nandi Hills. So let me tell you something else. I wasn't able to make the videos from so many days. I was actually busy and could not travel to Kolkata due to some reasons. So I could not show you what was happening there. I'm extremely sorry for that because I kind of promised you all. And Durga Puja wasn't that great this year. We had our Navami's Ghat Pujo yesterday, as I told you in my previous video, in my Durga Puja preparations video. I did not go yesterday because it was raining, and suddenly there's an awful climate change in Bangalore. It just rains, it's sunny, and it's like all different. But here in Nandi Hills, it is sunny, but the weather is just magnificent. I mean, it's windy, it's sunny, it's all together the perfect weather. And this is like a stand, and it's built beautifully here so that tourists can hang out in this place. And you know, most of the people aren't wearing masks here, which is weird. So you can see this beautiful view there. You can see some more hills. Nandi Hills is one of the most nearest hills to Bangalore and one of the most popular tourist destinations. Bangalore means Nandi Hills. It's about 60 kilometers away from Bangalore and 10 kilometers kilometers away from Chikbalapura, and it's near Devanahalli as well. So what we did was we came from the fort. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'm just telling you, if you've never visited Nandi Hills, it's a great place to visit. You can come plan a weekend stop here. You will love it. You can have a small picnic. You can see those nice sights I told you about, the sources of the rivers, the fall point, and then there's this suicide point here, which is really high. So they don't permit anyone to go there nowadays, but it's an awesome place to visit. So if you're thinking where to come this weekend, Nandi Hills is one of your best choices. I'm telling you because I'm here this weekend, the weather is pleasant. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you've liked it, please don't forget to like, comment down below if you need any other type of video. I'll be back very soon. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press on the bell icon to receive notifications from my channel whenever I come up with any activity. Bye, have a great day, and happy Dussehra once again.